Hello, this video is about how to download and install VirtualBox in Windows 8.1. The outcomes for this video would be to download Oracle VirtualBox, verify the download using an MD5 checksum, install VirtualBox in Windows 8.1, and then demonstrate a running virtual machine. Turning off Hyper-V is not covered in this video. Hyper-V and VirtualBox cannot be run at the same time on a Windows machine. Requirements: Windows 8.1 operating system with administrative privileges, Microsoft File Checksum Integrity Verifier installed in Windows 8.1. This is optional. I demonstrated how to verify a checksum, but for most of the time I found that I really haven't had any problem with a VirtualBox download. And then of course you need an internet connection. Additional info, there's the VirtualBox site, and then if you want, this is where you get the Microsoft File Checksum Integrity Verifier, and then I've got a video here how to use it. In this case, the video works with a Kali Linux file, but it works the same. And then there's another link here that says to switch easily between VirtualBox and Hyper-V. If you have Hyper-V enabled on your Windows 8.1, you've got two ways to do it. You can use the Windows Add Remove features where it's permanently removed, or a site like this which shows you how to do it by giving you a choice for when you actually boot up whether to enable Hyper-V or VirtualBox. And then there's a disclaimer. While I've researched this material, I can't fully verify that it will work with all combinations of hardware and software out, so I've been asked to include a disclaimer. If you wish, you can stop the video and read the disclaimer. Here I am at www.virtualbox.org, where you have to go to download VirtualBox and then go to the downloads page. In this case, this is for a Windows machine. The download will be for Windows 8.1. And so both 32 and 64-bit downloads are the same. So I simply click on VirtualBox 4.3.16 for Windows hosts. And then down at the bottom, it asks you want to run or save VirtualBox. And I'm going to click Save As, because I normally like to create the downloads in a separate directory on the C drive. And in this case, it's Downloads and then VirtualBox. And simply click Save. And if you notice, you'll see it's got a few seconds remaining. So we've got 1 second remaining. If I want to view the download or open a folder, make sure it's there, I simply open the folder and there it is. To verify that there were no problems with the download of Windows 4.3.16, I'm going to use the MD5 checksum. Click on this, and here is the MD5 checksum for WinXE. I'm going to just simply copy that whole line, right click, copy, and then I'm going to paste it into a notepad file, paste, and I'm going to add MD5, or let me know that this is MD5 checksum. For some reason, the tool I have from Microsoft won't do an SHA 256 checksum. File, Save As, and it's going to be in the same directory as Downloads and VirtualBox. And I'm simply going to call it checksum VB for VirtualBox 3.16. And click Save. And I can go ahead and close this now. So my next step is to open up a DOS prompt. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to CD to the C downloads directory, wherever the checksum and VirtualBox are located. Locating in the same directory make this a little bit easier to work with. Do a dir, and then I'm going to do cd v then I and then tab to get to VirtualBox. Do a dir again, and that tells me what's in that directory. To verify the checksum, I'm going to use the Microsoft File Check Integrity Verifier tool, FCIV. I've already installed on this computer. If you want to know how to install it, I've included the web address where you could get this tool and a short video on how to use this tool in the additional info section on my PowerPoint at the beginning of this video. And I'm going to say ASH MD5 because that's the checksum I'm using. And then I'm going to give it the file name, simply V and tab. Then I'm going to append the checksum that comes out to the checksum file. And hit enter. If you've got a slower computer, this might take a few minutes or two. I know it does on my Celeron processor. Then I'm going to go to Notepad, do a file, open. Here it is. It's appended to the original MD5 checksum. If you wish, you can go ahead and visually check it, or you can do it using code from the command line. I'm just going to use code. In order to use a little bit of code to verify the checksum, I need to have the checksum notepad open. And I'm going to move it over here to the side so it doesn't disappear on me. I'm going to use if and then a slash I, basically ignore the case, then come over here, see if I can copy this starting at the 2, copy, paste, and then a space, and then 2 equals, then copy the second checksum, which was done using the MD5 command from FCIV. Hit a space, and then open parentheses, which is above the 9 on the US keyboard. Simply type in echo match else, then another parentheses. Echo no match, whatever it doesn't matter, whatever you put in there, no match, whatever you want to put in there, doesn't work, not verified, whatever, and then hit enter, and you'll notice that says match. Just to verify if this is working, I will go over here, change one of these, change a C to a 3, hit enter, and you'll see it's not match. And that's how to verify that downloader file, in this case VirtualBox, has been downloaded correctly and there's no problem with the file. To install VirtualBox, simply go to the directory where you've downloaded VirtualBox. In my case, it's local disk C downloads VirtualBox. I'd right click on it and simply click open. And basically what this will do, it'll start the VirtualBox install program. And then you've got the welcome to the setup wizard. Click Next, and then asks what features will be installed. In my case, I always install all the features that I can on the hard drive, basically except the default. Then click Next, and you've got 3 checkboxes, and tells you where you want a shortcut on desktop or on the quick launch bar. That's up to you. I'm going to create a shortcut on desktop, but not on the quick launch bar. And then register file associations. Basically, VirtualBox uses certain file associations such as .mdk or .vbox for when you create a new virtual machine. And this registers those with Windows in the registry. Click Next. It gives you a warning, network interfaces will have to go down, and basically what's going on here is that it's going to change some network interfaces so your virtual machines will work with the network, and each time an interface is changed, then the network has to be restarted. So we'll proceed with the installation now. Click yes. And now we'll go and click on install. And this will come up. Do you want to allow the following program to install software on this computer? In this case, this is for VirtualBox. Second time on Windows Security, device software, universal serial bus. That's so that your virtual machine can use the USB. Click install. Now you saw a warning come up about connection. And click to finish to exit the setup wizard. Click finish. And here it is. Welcome to VirtualBox. You can go ahead and create your new virtual machines and install different operating systems. Now, this video doesn't cover how to create a virtual machine. In the next section, I'll just show you that this is actually working. Just to demonstrate that this install works, I have installed an Ubuntu 14.04 demo virtual machine inside VirtualBox. I have plenty of videos on my channel on how to install a virtual machine into VirtualBox. I'm going to start this. Now, one area where you may have a problem is if Hyper-V is enabled in your Windows 8.1 machine. One of the things you can do is you can go to the Windows Add Remove Features and remove Hyper-V, or you can take a look at the link I've had in the additional info section on how to enable Hyper-V or disable Hyper-V during boot up. And I'm going to get rid of these messages here. And I'm going to go to open up an internet connection. And here, these items right here, VirtualBox menus, and these items right here, down here, are menus from the Ubuntu 14.04 install. Also down here, you've got some more menu items from VirtualBox. So that's pretty much it. Thank you.